Alrighty, so we're back with another Kings Island 2020 construction update. And so a 6-0 Diesel Rage and Adrenaline.Obsession on Instagram and YouTube. Go check them both out. I will link them at the end of the video and in the description, as they have been super helpful and super open to sharing some footage with us so we can cover this project. So as you can tell from this airplane footage, the land clearing has grown. As I put in the, pinned message or text in my last video, we were looking for growth in the land clearing, and it looks like that's exactly what's happened. And I have even better news. The outer edges of the land clearing have flags, and those flags are resembling Do Not Cross here. And the land clearing where it ends currently does not have those flags. So that's a really good sign. I've been analyzing the pictures that have been sent to me really closely as I followed Yukon Striker's construction project really closely, and I've been able to talk to people in construction about what things mean. So I actually do have a really good understanding of construction. I guess that's the one thing I bring to the table that I understand greatly. But super exciting. I definitely think the land clearing is going to grow lengthwise even more. And I actually am starting to think that those red storage buildings with that little white silo down there next to Flight of Fear are going to be moved elsewhere in the park, as that is the only location that I could see a midway going for this new attraction. So I definitely think we're going to see those buildings coming down and moved elsewhere. I'm actually seeing signs in the back area of what looks like they could be building more storage buildings to compensate for the loss of these ones if they do choose to remove them. So I definitely think we'll see a midway in that area. That's my guess. But here's a close-up from Adrenaline Obsession of the land clearing. It has grown, I would probably guess, around 50 feet in a week, and that's pretty big. It probably is even larger than 50 feet. Again, it is hard to measure the distance from this far back and high up, but it's definitely grown a lot. The coaster layout is definitely getting way too big for a wing coaster. It is starting to rule some things out. If this grows anymore, it's definitely going to be the Kings Island Giga that everyone is hoping for. Again, I was looking for more land clearing, and we got exactly that. So that's super exciting. It's definitely looking very Giga-like as it continues to grow. It's definitely looking, in my opinion, based off of the land clearing I'm seeing in the work in a different area, it's looking like it's going to have a very out and back layout, and we're talking a very long out and back layout, and then it might even come back towards the station and head up that service road and then work its way back. So I'm definitely going to stick to my prediction that if this is a Kings Island Giga, it's going to break the records of Fury. I do think they're going to go after the records for world's, well, I don't think they can go for world's tallest due to Red Force, but it's definitely going to be North America's tallest, fastest, longest Giga. If it's a wing coaster, it's the same thing. They're going to break records for sure with the current plot of land we're seeing. Again, it is just in Cedar Fair's equation to continuously break their own records. It protects them from other parks swooping in and taking those records. Now, I don't know if I discussed this in the previous video. A lot of people are noticing that there's cones all over the construction site currently where Firehawk used to sit. Again, sometimes the cones can mark, you know, sewers or areas to be careful of, and that is the case in a lot of situations. But what you want to be looking out for is lettering and numbers on those cones. Because, again, Yukon Striker did use cones to mark where the footers are going in a lot of situations. That, you know, a lot of coasters, they use the stakes that people are used to seeing with the letter, you know, a C and then a number for the which column it's going to be on the layout. But Yukon Striker, actually about 80% of the coaster used giant columns or those little orange cones that you see to mark where the footings were going to go. So again, if anyone can check for markings on those, that would help a lot. It could tell you a lot. You know, if you see column like 200 or something, it's going to tell you it's going to be a really long coaster. Anyways, other than that, there's lots of land clearing going on. Each week you guys go back to the park, there's more land clearing. Hopefully, you know, come this Friday, there's even more. Because if there is an even longer layout come this Friday, we're ruling out a wing coaster. Or I am at least ruling out a wing coaster, and I'm definitely sticking to it's just going to be the Kings Island Giga that everyone's waiting for. But anyways, hopefully you guys enjoyed this really quick update. Again, go check out Adrenaline Obsession on YouTube. and Instagram, and 6O Diesel Rage on Instagram and YouTube as well. Thank you for letting me use your footage. And hopefully you guys have a great week. And I definitely am looking forward to this weekend's coverage at Kings Island. Thanks so much, guys. Have a great one. Bye.